Something that I wish existed for me or my family when I was diagnosed terminal would definitely be the support for my parents, the idea that they're going to bury their youngest to cancer, and I can't find any information. I went on a huge search a number of years ago for information for my mom having a daughter with breast cancer, and I couldn't find it. I could find children's books for if mommy has breast cancer. I could find older books if you're dealing with, you know, your senior mother has breast cancer. I couldn't find anything the other way around. And I know it's not supposed to go the other way around, but in my case, and in many cases, it does. Nothing exists for my parents. I can't find anything for my husband, who is really young. I think of him after I'm gone going to like a widower, not speed dating, that sounds awful, but just something connecting with other people. He's not going to find anybody his age. I've often made the joke that maybe he could date Celine Dion because she has experienced loss, and she's not too much older than my husband, so I feel like they would be a good match. I don't know, matchmaking, I don't know. There are so many things that are missing, especially in the palliative setting for people with who are young with metastatic cancer, with stage 4 cancer. I think about the financial issues that we just, I don't know how we do it. I don't know how day to day, and I mean, there's no savings, there's no retirement plan, we'll say. For me, that doesn't much matter. For my husband, it does, and I think about that quite often, about all the financial obstacles that we have, but also that he'll have after I'm gone. I am lucky enough to have some kind of long-term disability income, but it's not very much. So when I'm gone, what does my husband do? We bought a 4-bedroom house with every intention of having children, and then that decision was made for us. So how do we balance that? I mean, it's silly for us to live in this home. It'd be even sillier for him to live here by himself. So everything absolutely changes once we're gone, or once I'm gone. That's something that we never really realized, or these decisions that we make day to day, how many decisions we have to make. This is so simple, but getting a new passport. Do I get the 10-year? Do I tempt fate and get the 10-year? Or do I go 5-year? Because it's going to save us $60, and that $60 is going to go towards groceries. And these simple, I went with the 10-year, by the way. I know you're dying to know. I went with the 10-year because I thought I'm willing to risk the $60 and whatever, I don't know how much it is, but I'm willing to risk it. But there are so many decisions that we have to make. A phone plan, my phone plan's coming up, and it's under my husband's name, because it costs, I don't know, $50 to transfer it into my name. So do I leave it in my husband's name and then I pass away and then he's stuck with an 18-month contract? These decisions come up consistently about just these tough things that you don't realize are part of it, are part of having cancer. And I think being young offers a lot of challenges as well, because you have people around you who aren't going through retirement. They're going through the amount of baby showers that I go to, or weddings, which I mean, I'm grateful for. I'm so happy that my friends get to experience this, but it is quite challenging to continually go and kind of pretend like everything is okay, and I don't want to be Cancer Katie, and I want to be the way that I've always been, but with the continual, knowing that the cancer's progressing and the continual side effects, it just seems to be so challenging, just endlessly, and knowing that I'm not going to get any better. Things are only going to get worse.